Hi, I'm Mike, independent camera repair technician, and I'm starting featurecamera.org to show you the photo gear industry from a different point of view. No specs, no marketing BS, talking about things you won't hear anywhere else. Welcome. If you'll ever attempt to work on a lens, any lens, it's quite likely that you will find out that some parts are permanently stuck and they won't move no matter how much force you apply to them. And by forcing those parts, it's almost certain that you'll cause a lot of damage, and this damage is gonna be much worse to fix than the actual problem you were having with your lens. It's a very common problem for all DIY people trying to fix their own cameras and lenses at home, and also for new technicians that come to work and they just don't know yet how to deal with this problem. In simple words, in this job, if something doesn't come off easily, there is a reason for that, and it usually means that you are doing something wrong. Okay, so why these parts are stuck so badly? It's because manufacturers are using kind of a glue to protect some parts from getting loose over time. It's called 3-bond. There are 3 colors available, but mostly you will see only 2, red and blue. And when it's dry, it looks like this. It's slightly blue or slightly red and kind of a clear, translucent, rather soft type of glue. So you can easily recognize this if you look closely at those parts. Now, how to deal with this? One of the properties of this glue, I always call it a screw lock, by the way, is that it's based on alcohol. Alcohol is the main solvent within this thing, and this is because unlike acetone or many other aggressive solvents, it is safe for plastics and paint. So you can safely apply the screw lock to almost anything. The alcohol evaporates quickly and leaves this hard residue which protects parts from moving. But cameras and lenses have to be serviced from time to time, and this means that they have to be disassembled. And that's why manufacturers are using this 3-bond screw lock instead of a super glue, for example. Because it can be dissolved easily by using alcohol, which again, unlike acetone, is safe for plastics and paint. One more magic ingredient that you need here is some patience. I usually apply the alcohol once, wait about a minute, apply it the second time, and wait another minute and it comes off easily. From time to time, I come across a stubborn one, and it takes 5 or 6 times, but it always works. For very old lenses, the manual type, it might take several times and some heat, like for example a preheating table or a hairdryer to get it to about 50 or 60 Celsius degrees. I don't work on this type of lenses, so I'm lucky here, but I've seen some other technicians dealing with these. Newer lenses are usually much easier when it comes to this. So let's try with this one now. One thing I want you to remember from this video, if you are going to ever attempt any lens or camera repair, is if something doesn't come off easily, it means that you are doing something wrong. Don't force anything. Because even though it looks like a metal part, it's usually a soft type of metal, aluminum or some other alloys, easy to damage. And once the damage is done, it's very hard to deal with it. And from time to time I get such a lens or camera on my bench. It looks normal from the outside, but there is a nice disaster waiting for me inside. Of course there is no mention about this on the paperwork. The customer just forgot to mention this completely unimportant detail, probably thinking that nobody's going to notice it. It's a pain, it's a huge pain in the back. So in such cases I try to guess how much additional time it's going to take, if it's possible to fix those broken parts easily, or if not, then if those parts are easily available. If not, I try to find if we have some used parts from the same make and model. If not, then from similar models. And then depending on what I found, sometimes I re-estimate this repair for a higher price. To be honest, in some cases, truly hoping that the customer is going to refuse this new estimate. It's just a pain, so please be careful. The next video, I think it's gonna be about using a lens spanner. It's a very common and a very useful tool, but in the wrong hands, the amount of damage it can do is unbelievable. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. I have many more videos coming soon with teardowns and reviews and repair tips and photo gear related stuff. If you have any questions related to these topics, please let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching and see you next time.